Right, so we're going to have a look at my tool bag. If you follow my channel, you'd see that I recently put all my tools back into this bag. So it's still heavy, it's still getting on for 15 kilos, but these are the tools you need to do your job. So I'll just start on the side. This, I don't use that often, to be fair. This is if you're scaling off of big drawings, okay? I only just put this, there's a tape measure. I only just put this big hammer back in because I didn't really use it that much, but I needed this the other day. That's clear. This side, obviously, we've got the armoured slice, okay? And a square, definitely essential if you're doing trunking and you want a square. Cut things square, and a little head torch in there, yeah? Front of the bag, quick socket tester. Obviously, you don't use these to prove dead. You just use these if you're trying to find a circuit and you're, you know, the consumer unit's miles that way, you can hear these. They have a visual and an audio. Just some little Milwaukee impact bits and an array of tapes and some sleeving in the front there. And the reason I like this bag is because this section actually does come out. Yeah, it's a nice feature of this bag. In the bottom, junior hacksaw goes next to that. Pencil sharpener goes back in there.
Did you say pencil sharpener?
Pencil sharpener,
you
yeah.
Don't use your knife then, you actually have a pencil sharpener.
I do, for the big pencils, builder's pencils. These are just for cutting plastic conduit, plastic trunking. Again, two sets of adjustable spanners for doing up armoured glands. These ones will only go up to the 20 mil. These ones go up to 25 to 30s. Mole grips. Grips. Pad saw. Allowed to use these? Pad saw?
Yes, yeah, yeah. We use pad saw, yeah. We have got a multi-tool as well, but we show them it and don't let them use it. So no, we go old school again.
Metal cutters.
So we'd call them tin snips.
Tin
probably.
Snips, yep. And a set of Allen keys / hex keys. Is that what you call them?
Yep.
What's in there? And a punch down tool for, this is, the real one is called a Krona tool. This is actually a Krona tool, okay, for doing Cat 6 cables. And you can do BT with this as well.
Are you finding more and more people are wanting connected Wi-Fi in their houses now when you're rewiring them? Are you finding that's a thing?
Yeah, I've had to put some wired data points in straight off the BT or the Sky Hub, whichever they've got, and they plug straight in then. Top of the bag, I've got a couple of comb cutters, okay?
Okay.
They're just handy when you need them here all the time, so they're just in here. I think that's just random. I've got a charger for something in there. So that's now empty. And then in the bag here, you've got, this is my best tool ever. People laugh, but it's awesome. Hammer, a knife.
Do you mind asking me why half a hammer makes a good hammer? Because it looks very small.
Okay, so obviously you don't want to be knocking walls down with this, but if you're clipping twin and earth cables all day long, you don't, this is look, the force you've got to put with that, whereas the force you can do with that is, it just saves your arm all day. One day, I think I clipped 600 clips, and I needed that, so it was great.
Have you thought about getting a DeWalt cable stapler, which we quite like? They are four times quicker than clipping by hand.
They are, but they're four times expensive as well.
I reckon you'll save your time back in three jobs.
That's it. Again, just a little quick initial check. If you've got a cable running through a trunking and you just want to check it, you can just check it like that. These aren't obviously for checking dead. Roughneck. Level with the magnet, so you can easily magnetise on the bottom of the consumer unit because they're metal now. A little set here. I used this yesterday actually for doing up a, because it's got the nut driver, you can put it on your impact gun and do bolts up easy with it. Set of Bosch, what do you call them? Wood
spade
bits?
Yeah.
Wood spade bits, yeah. These ones have got the thread that actually pulls it into the wood so you're not trying to fight the drill. They stay in the bag because this is something that you always use, like with the cone cutters. Pencils and the Marksman, these are fantastic.
Oh, we love the Marksman. Now you're getting on with that.
Yeah, fantastic.
How long would you say they last?
This lasts about, it would only last one job, like one rewire, if you was doing a rewire.
So, yeah, okay.
So it's one per job, £5 or whatever they are. So it's a good investment though. A couple of pens and pencils, and then you just come to screwdrivers really. it's random sleeving. So insulated side cutters, long nose pliers and pliers, okay. Some little 6-inch chompers.
Are you obsessed with, by looking at your toolkit, I don't want to suggest you're not, are you obsessed with sticking to a certain brand?
No.
Or no?
No.
Okay.
I've used screwdrivers that have cost £10 each and the next day they've snapped.
Okay.
And I've used a set of screwdrivers like the Magnusons. I'm not plugging anyone. I've had this set for 6 months now and not one has broke. Okay. So it just goes to show that the manufacturer and the price doesn't always count for quality. Okay, got your taps, your dies, taps, whatever you want to call them, for doing the threads in the boxes, because you will come across. So the standard is a 4mm and a 3.5. Standard screwdrivers, PZs, big chompers for doing bigger cables, especially the 16mm and 25mm meter tails.
Have you ever used the 19 core ones? The 19 core 25mm squared tails? Would you use the 7-core ones that are quite hard to wrestle?
Oh, you're on about the easy ones to press in. Yeah, I've used the set the other day, actually.
And what's your thinking?
Love them, yeah.
Yeah, they're
really nice.
Yeah, fantastic.
So easy to dress into the top of the main switch there.
Two fingers to bend them.
That's it.
It's just ridiculous.
So these pliers I've had since I started my apprenticeship. So these are...
So they are an heirloom almost?
Yeah, sort of. They're quite stiff now, but they do. I like them because they've got the old... You don't use them now, but they've got the old crimping lug on the bottom there. Set of, if I can get them out.
So if you left those pliers on a job, and that job was a 50-mile round trip, would you go back
yes.
and get them?
Yes, definitely.
So would I, if I've been with them that long.
Yeah, okay, set of crimps for doing 1.5, 2.5 and 6 mils. Red, yellows and blues. Screwdrivers. Paintbrush, not for painting, obviously just for cleaning out boxes and consumer units. Round file, I've lost my flat file, which I'm a bit annoyed about, but... It doesn't matter. Rubber hammer. And then what else we got? That is it. Yep. That is just the basic toolkit that I've compressed three boxes down to.
So that's your walk-in. Yep. Maybe someone's got a problem. You're doing a quote. You're going to take a few covers off and all the rest of it.
Yep.
But you could get away with doing small works with it.
Yeah.
And then major jobs, you're obviously bringing and lumping the rest of your kit in.
That's it.
That's fantastic toolkit. We're going to bring the students in now closer to have a look. We'll give him a clap. Thank you very much.